Okay, so what happens now moving forward? PEDC-1 it's shut down right now. Is that correct?
No, I think both
It's open.
PEDC, as of 7:30 this morning, both
Okay.
PEDC units are already online.
Okay. So if they're both online, would it be correct, Attorney Dimalanta, that they should have power already?
No, because we still need one more plant to be online.
Okay.
That's the Pan Concepcion plant. And the indication is that it will be online by today. What we're asking for, what we're at, the question we're asking NGCP and the plant, we're going directly to the plant as well, is what time today can they estimate to start ramping up so that the power can stabilize?
Oh, I'm curious, Attorney, the POM plant, the third plant, is owned by another corporation, not
Yes,
already.
another corporation. That's right.
But did they also trip during the
Yes.
Janto blackout? That's
Yes.
interesting.
Yes. Six,
So,
I think six plants in total.
six plants in total trip, but the six plants are not owned by the same
That's
corporation.
correct. That's correct. That's correct.
But all the six plants are connected by NGCP.
That's correct.
Okay, so what do you deduce from that? I mean,
Well, that's why
six
we need
plants that
to.
are not owned by the same company, right? They all trip.
So you look for the common denominator, right?
Yes, yeah.
So that's why I was saying we need to investigate this further because it's impossible that all plants just decided to go offline all at the same
Yeah.
time, or that they all on their own failed at the same time. There must be something that led to, that led to those series or serial consequences among the generation plants.
Oh, so if the third plant opens, yung POM, which you're waiting for, so there's power already in PEDC-1, 2, and POM. Ideally, if there's nothing wrong with the NGCP grid, there should be power by this afternoon.
Yes, I in fact I'm looking at the latest. NGCP gives us about a report every 30 minutes. So
Okay.
as of the latest report of 8 o'clock is what I have here. Panay already has a generation capacity of 203 megawatts. It needs
Okay.
300 to stabilize. So
Uh-oh.
once Palm Concepcion, which is around 130, I think, one Palm Concepcion comes in, then NGCP will be able to stabilize the grid if supply is the sole issue.
Uh-oh. If supply, but if supply is there
Then
and
we'll know.
there's no power by this afternoon, that's important information in the investigation.
That's correct. That's correct.
Okay. All right. So my last question, I guess, is the challenges of NGCP. This isn't the first challenge NGCP is facing. Clearly, you know the operations like the back of your hand. What makes it difficult for NGCP to actually, why do they face these challenges? One might say, can't they do a better job? What's the hindrance? What are the obstacles?
I wouldn't say I know the operations like the back of my hand. The system operations is a very tough job.
Yeah.
And it's as I mentioned earlier, the energy system is a complex system. It has become more complex with the introduction, admittedly, of more renewables in the system. And the grid was not built to accommodate large renewables, large volumes of renewables. So the grid also has to evolve. And what we're feeling right now, I think, are the we're in an evolution phase of the system. We need to all, get our act together to make sure that the all parts of the system can work. If we really want, if we really want our system to become more resilient and more sustainable in the future. So I will not hazard at this point, but we will once we complete our investigation of what NGCP can do better, what the generators can do better. So I'm not prepared now, but we will get there. We will get to the point where we can tell all the stakeholders, let's do this better, and this is what we need to do in greater detail.
No, because you've talked about the evolution, the complexity, the changes. And it's interesting you said that the grid was not built for large-scale renewables. And that's interesting because we are moving towards renewables, right? President Marcos Jr. issued a moratorium on coal. So anything that's coming into the market, to the grid, is all renewables. When there are threats of recall the franchise, you can revoke the franchise. Does this help? Frankly, because it's not that easy to balance the conversation. If you're NGCP, right? It's like you're under threat all the time.
Well, one, let me just correct. It was President Duterte who issued the moratorium on coal. But
Oh, okay, go ahead.
President Marcos Jr. is really pushing forward with more renewables. You know, th this policy on offshore wind development is a huge one. And if we want to really attract investors to go into offshore wind, we better address our grid issues, because that's a bigger change that we're introducing in the grid. So to answer your question on whether NGCP, you know, to be fair to NGCP, but you know, maybe I'll answer it this way. All public utilities that are issued franchises are faced with that, what you call, quote unquote, constant threat of revocation, because they always need to be on their toes. Monopolies have to be on their toes all the time, because it's only a privilege. A privilege, you know, you don't have. The Supreme Court has said this many times. It is not a matter of right, it's a matter of privilege. So that threat is, I would think, is par for the course for a regulated entity. That's why they need to be constantly improving, always evolving, also with the challenges of the times.
Attorney, I guess what can we expect today? I mean, to end.
We expect, hopefully, that Palm Concepcion facility will start to be online, so that NGCP can be given the supply to stabilize the grid. We are issuing, well, NGCP is issuing an early update on this one, and we hope to get more details on the exact time that the facility will be online, so that we can give finally a relief to our kababayans in Panay on this one. But moving forward, we'll of course, as I mentioned earlier, we'll complete our investigation.
Yes, all right. On that note, when you do an investigation, does the ERC have the power to recommend, or in other words, to Congress, in terms of the performance of, let's say, a particular, like this?
Yes. Yes, we do. Yes, we do.
Okay. All right. On that note, I want to thank you so much. And I do hope to hear from you again regarding this issue. Thank you.
Thank you. Good morning.
And Happy New Year. Happy New Year
Happy
to
New
you.
Year.
All right. Energy Regulatory Chairperson Mona Lisa de Malanta. Thank you, ma'am.